We all average probably about 5 hours of sleep.
It's 4:45 a.m. It's still dark outside. Look at that. The lights just went out, and I'm getting ready to kill this AM cardio. You can't even see me, but it's going to be so good, it's bad.
Focus!
If you do anything, you never want to do anything half-assed, especially when it comes to your training. Get in, be intense, execute on it, and then get out. For a lot of guys out there, and I was certainly one of those guys, in my 20s, I thought I had all the answers. I didn't know shit, by the way. In my 30s, I'm still trying to find myself, as a lot of guys are out there. Hopefully, when you hit your 40s, you're hitting a nice stride. If I'm going to do it, I need to do this job right. I need to stay focused on it. I need to give the best effort I possibly can.
All right, empty gym, the way we'd like it. It's Sunday, just finished my warm-up. This pain ought to be fun.
Focus!
I work out twice before everyone wakes up.
All right, workout number two. I'm out working all my competition. All right, Saturday afternoon, empty gym, the way we like it. It's leg day, which means it's gonna be sweaty, painful, and fun.
Focus!
Peep the stinking Jones, bruh. You know I had to pull out the flamingos today. I had to pull out the flamingos today, bruh. Hey. Before they munch on it, I do want to expand it. Oh, it's only that. There's no use. There's no use, so let's throw it.
When you're on a golden sea.
Oh my gosh, bruh. That is not cool. There we go. Take a soft left. Jabroni's on the way to Home Depot because... guess why? I had another yapping rooster start crowing. I'm surprised it lasted this long without needing the collar. I didn't know if he was gonna crow or not. Yeah, he started crowing this morning at like 6 a.m. I can't have that, bro. Now, y'all are tripping. I cannot park down there, bro. I mean, oh yeah, it's still open. Oh my. All right, y'all better back up. Back. Oh my gosh, that lighting. And it's hot as f-. See, cause I can go with that. But that, oh, see, no, I just need a full shirt. Oh, here we go. I might just do the 4x4. Not that one. I think I'm gonna do this one though. But see how I got the one with the sticker on one side rather than the one with all those little grooves right there? That's still 4 inches by 2 inches. This is 4 inches by 2 inches. Except this is stick on right here. If it's too much, you could always cut it down, but for right now, we're gonna do 4 inches long by 2 inches wide. Now Jabroni's gotta get to the other side of the store, bruh. See? Hey, it's all so easy. It's all so easy. After everything, it was $3 and some change. It was like $3.25.
This stuff is starting now. It's the same feeling. I always seem to get a
It's been like a week since the last clip and a ton of stuff has been going on back here. I'd just feel bad if I didn't show y'all. First off, the youngsters. Come on, girls. Let's do it. Let me see. I gotta get you. They've been wondering about you, bruh. So, a few weeks ago, I had a comment from a lady. Miss Anna Mendoza, she asked, why does the collar work? A chicken, like humans, has a pair of lungs, but they also have a posterior and an anterior air sac. So they've also got excess air sacs. When he crows, what he's doing is he's expanding his neck muscles out and relieving that excess air that he's got from those two air sacs. To answer your question, how does the rooster collar work? Well, the point of the rooster collar isn't to squeeze his neck any tighter than it is normally. It's more to make sure he's not able to expand his neck in a, you know, widely fashion. He could still eat, he could still drink. You know, I see him take down lizards, but we just can't have him growing. I don't know what we're gonna do with him. We'll probably have to make some enchiladas or something. Tostadas, I don't know. But yeah, I'm not gonna squeeze his neck. I'm not gonna make his neck tighter than it is now and than it is normally. I'm just making sure that he's not gonna be able to expand his neck muscles just in a huge, wide fashion, you know, so I'm able to put my finger in there. Another trick is when you've got the collar on him, I like to just make the point where the two seams in the Velcro meet up and it's got that like void in the Velcro right there. I like to face it in front of him. I just feel like that's got a lot more give than like the plain Velcro just straight up that side. I want to see him take down those lizards and those scorpions. We just can't have them crowing, so that's the number one thing. I've got a lot more stuff to show y'all. I've got the plants, I got the baby chicks, I've got some eggs hatching. It's just going down. In that coop over there, I've got my Easter egger hens with the barred rock rooster. I want to hatch those Easter egger eggs, but I don't know about the barred rock rooster. If I'm hatching eggs from the Easter eggers, I want them to breed true. Or there's a lady local here who's got some excess like black copper Moran roosters. She's wondering if I want one. I might do it. I'm thinking about it. But the eggs that he'd make would give out olive eggers. So I'm thinking I might do it. Hold up. They're being loud. I just gotta let them out. Do their thing for a little bit. Come on, Lionel. Get out, boy. There you go. This is the one that I didn't want out. So I definitely gotta get her. She's small enough to fit through the gate right there. I got my dog on the other side and I ain't trying to have her be lunch.
Steps up. Fires. Mike Sims Walker. Oh, he caught him.
This is what I've been waiting to show y'all. I've been, you know what? I'm gonna just show y'all. Put her back with her friends. I just can't have her roaming around the yard yet when my dog's in the pool and stuff. She slips through that gate and my dog's on her. Enter the lion's den and we got the babies. My pride and joys right here. Here she is. These tomatoes are really looking nice right now. I've definitely got to transplant them out of these tiny little cups. I can see their roots already on the bottom. Like these babies are ready. Babies already got a little bit of algae, but nothing to worry about. The next video is definitely gonna be me transplanting these into the ground. I've got some special stuff ready for y'all. Actually, I'm gonna take these out. These were some winter things that I had going, but didn't do very well. I can't remember which ones were which, but there's definitely cherry tomatoes in there along with what was it? Delicious tomatoes. Okay, so they're kind of like beef steaks. And then right here I've got my squash. I started some watermelon. I mean, a couple of them ain't really doing too nice, but this one looks like it's good. This one will do good. The one behind it will do good. I'll have some. Oh, I've got more squash here, a couple cucumbers, broccoli that I don't know is gonna do good. It's more of a winter thing, but I'll still do it. And more squash. The next video is definitely most likely gonna involve me transplanting those plants into the ground because they're ready. They need to start eating, getting that good nutrients from the native soil and from my mix. Hey, we're going for the Guinness Book this year. We're going for the 10 pound mater, I swear. If we don't hit it though, I ain't even gonna be tripping, but I'm going for it. I'm gonna pull out all the tricks that I got up my sleeve. Y'all ain't gonna wanna miss it, so the next vid, tune in. Got some treats. My mom gave me this. It's some ground beef from like last week that we went on a vape where she was just gonna throw it away, but it's perfect for the chicks and the chickens. This is straight protein. And people might not find it normal to give chickens meat. I mean, what they don't know is that chickens are omnivores. They're not supposed to primarily live off of greens, you know? They need animal protein to be healthy. In the chick stage, they're growing. The more protein, the better, really. They could have too much protein, but it's kind of hard to do that. I mean, if they have access to other foods, and like how I've got them on grass, and then I also give them a grain too on top of everything, you know what I'm saying? So they get a very well-rounded diet. If you don't end up giving your chickens protein, a lot of times what they end up doing is they start pecking each other's feathers. They'll start, like, one will like start pecking on like a weaker chicken's feathers, and the next thing you know, you got a chicken with a bald back and stuff like that, and like a bald head, and you're like, why is this chicken pecking its feathers? A feather is like 90% protein. They get protein in like a commercial bag of pellets and a commercial bag of feed, but I just like to do this type of stuff as treats, and like I give it to them really every day. When I'm giving them animal protein, they just act different. They act like chickens, and they stink it, and they just love it. Done with the yapping, I haven't even showed y'all what I got here. These ones are actually brother and sister from the same mom and dad. This is the boy, this is the girl. They're called red sex links, red stars. Yeah, I think, yeah, because I definitely know they're called red stars. They've got a few different names. Oh, I can't have her go inside the pool gate. This is a rescue mission now. Hold up, bro, we gotta work fast. She knows, she ain't going in the pool. There you go, bro, get back in there. That's what I got going down. I've got my citrus going. I got my roses going. I've got my stinking squash going, my tomatoes. My chickens are living life lavish. I'm maximizing space to the full potential, and it's gonna be sick. So tune in next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Go to my Instagram, show me mad love right there. I'm gonna see y'all on the next one.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what